so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in him shall not perish, but shall have everlasting life. We come to you today with a free gift, the gift of God's eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. You say, why are you coming? Why are you bothering us here at the farmer's market? Because the Bible says, go in all the world and preach the gospel. You're not going to hear this message in churches today. You're going to hear fairy tales and flowers and Easter bunnies. But we come to you with the gospel that the Lord Jesus Christ died and was buried according to the scriptures and arose again that you may have life and have life more abundantly. We're here to preach to you the salvation sent by God, approved of God. We're not religion. Religion is man-made. Jesus Christ is God-approved. We're here about the precious Lamb of the Lamb of God, which take away the sin of the world, the Lord Jesus Christ. We're here about but nothing but the Lord Jesus Christ. Above all things, the Lord Jesus Christ, the one that went to Calvary and died for your sins, the Lord Jesus Christ, a name above all names, that the name of the Lord Jesus I shall bow down and declare that he is Lord. There is no name given amongst men whereby ye must be saved. Your life right now, your condition right now, no matter what your age is you are terminal. You will die. You will not escape death, for the wages of sin is death. You are a sinner, for all have sinned and come to short the glory of God. There is none righteous, no, not one. Because you are born of Adam and a sinner, you will die. And it's appointed unto men once to die, but after this, the judgment. The Bible says, prepare to meet thy God. And you better meet God with the blood, with the testimony of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, or you'll be damned to hell for all eternity. I said hell. I am sick and tired of people telling people to go to hell. I'm here to tell you, don't go to hell. Jesus saves. That's the Bible gospel truth. The Bible I hold in my hands, the words that I hold in this hand, the words I'm speaking to you, they are not my words. They are the words of the Holy God that came down that you may have life. This is what God has written to you. This Bible is for you, for all that you do. This is your role. What God sets is the standard. I don't care what you believe. I don't care what your church says. I don't care what your rabbi says. I don't care what your religion says. If it's not in the pages of the King James Bible, it is false. It is a lie. It is of the murderer, John 8:44. Let me read to you today out of a book rarely read, rarely opened by Christians. Open up an Old Testament book that's set aside, but it's very much good for today. I'm going to open up to the book of Habakkuk chapter 2. I didn't say Tabakka, I said Habakkuk. Some of you born again Christians out there going to heaven, you're going to meet Habakkuk one day. You have no idea who he is. But he's found in the pages of your Bible. Shame on you. You can tell me who the quarterback is, who the right fielder is, who's the star of the TV, but you can't tell me who Habakkuk is. Habakkuk chapter 2, I stand upon my watch. I set me upon the tower, and will watch to see what he will say unto me, and what I shall answer when I am reproved. I'm a sinner. God speaks to me. God is speaking to you through me. I've got plenty of reprovement meant by God in my life that I need to get right and confess under the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm a sinner just like you, but I'm saved by the blood. I have been saved since April 1987, where I asked the Lord Jesus Christ to save me. I invite him. I Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain upon tables, and he may run that readeth. I'm reading what Habakkuk wrote. 2015. For the vision is yet for appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. The word of God cannot lie. God is unable, will never, and cannot lie to you. Titus, Numbers. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come, it will not tarry. Listen, we've been preaching Jesus coming is a tarrying moment, but he is coming. And he will come at the moment that you are unaware. The church is unaware. Jesus is coming. That is a Bible fact that Jesus fulfilled 48 prophecies of his first coming 100%. And if he says he's coming, he's coming. See, the God of the Bible is a God of 100% prophecy. He won't settle for 99.77, 300, whatever that soap is. To God, it has to be 100%. How do you know that this is the God of the Bible? 100% prophecy will be fulfilled 100%. No loopholes. We are the God of the Bible of truth. Behold, his soul, which lifted up, is not upright in him, but the just shall live by his faith. Just people will live by the faith that is set by God, and that faith is in Jesus Christ. It's not set in money. It's not set in membership. It is not set in holidays. It is not set in friendship, family, or anything else but Jesus Christ. That is the faith of God. He also, because he transgressed by wine. We are a drinking nation. We are a nation that we rather have alcohol than church. Some churches even have alcohol. We are a drunken nation. We spend more money on booze than we do on missionaries, on the work of the Lord. We all live for TGIF. Let's get drunk. Let's get partying. Let's have a good time. That's what America lives for. That is what your neon signs, that's what your advertising, that's what your NASCAR, that is what is all around us. Alcohol. Alcohol destroys families. It destroys your body. And yet you keep going. You keep drinking. And one day when the doctor says your liver's all messed up, oh God, help me. No. May God give you more pain and agony to know about the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior. And had you instructed yourself what the Bible says, you wouldn't be in that condition. Condition that you are in is because of sin. God told us, thou shalt not, and you look for the loophole. God pre-warns man before he judges. God even tells you in a pack of cigarettes before you get that lung cancer, don't open up.
You shouldn't sound so angry.
I'm not angry.
Yeah, you are. You're angry.
It's funny. This woman made me mad, people! That's anger.
He's not angry.
It's not angry. You got to be amplified. You got to be able to people to hear. Alright. God warns man before the judgment comes. He sends us out in the streets to tell you that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, and judgment is coming. And judgment without the blood, without the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, will result in your condemnation. We read further. He is proud man. America is full of pride. What is the song? I'm proud to be American. No. Pride is of Satan. Pride is never of God. God says when he is pleased with you, well done. God never says pride or proud. Proud is a sin. One of the things that Habakkuk says is proud people made in the USA. Well, let me tell you, that's a piece of junk. I've had four cars made in America and they're a piece of junk. Because America doesn't care. America doesn't follow the Bible. America doesn't follow the rules. You got President Obama in office because that's who you deserve. God will give a nation a leader that it deserves. Proud is a sin. Pride will keep you from turning to God. Pride will keep you from going to God or your pastor for help.
I love Obama.
Neither keepeth at home. Here we go again with America. No one's home anymore. There is no family dinner table. There's no family devotion. There's no family church time. There's no time at home. We're always on the move. We're going. We're here. We're there. We got plans. We've got to-do lists. We got our phones. We got planners. We got everything but God. You got a million things you got to do today, and you haven't even thanked God for getting out of bed today. Habakkuk is speaking to America, who enlarges his desires as hell and as in death. America, Americans, are off to heaven or hell. Heaven by the precious blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, hell by anything but. Listen, people are cast into hell for one reason today. Their rejection of the Lord Jesus Christ as their Savior. You are a sinner. And Christ died and was buried and rose again for your sins. You need to have your sins washed in the blood of the Lamb of God, which take away the sin of the world, or you cannot get to heaven. You will not get to heaven. You cannot be in heaven outside the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. And if you got a religion, your religion will be in hell with you for all eternity, and all the leaders thereof.
To hear your big mouth.
A lot of people in here, sir, and you need to hear. Jesus Christ can have came that you may have life. Jesus Christ came that you need life. Jesus Christ came to offer to you a free gift, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but shall have everlasting life. And I'll tell you how proud you Americans are. You have a constitution, but you want me to shut up. Your constitution says I have a right to be here, I have a right to speak, so you shut up. Why ain't you out here publicizing your God, whatever you believe in? Why ain't you out here with what your book said? You ain't out here because you ain't got nothing. I stand out here because I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. I'm telling you that he is the way, the truth, and I'm offering you hope. What do you got? What do you got? My hope is free. Your hope, you need cash or credit card. And once your money's gone, your hope is gone. And you know it. But this hope that's found in this Bible is for all eternity. It's a fruit of God, love, joy, peace. And it's free. And we are offering to you without price. No CDs, no shipping and handling. It is for you to have free of charge right now. We'll open up the Bible and show you. The Bible says, what must I do to be saved? Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Plain and simple. What must I do to be saved in America? Cash, check, or money order. You got no cash? You don't get it. Got no insurance? You don't get it. Jesus says, come unto me, all ye that are heavy laden, all ye that burden, come unto me. Habakkuk chapter 2. An evil covetousness to his house, that he might set his nest on high, that he may be delivered from the power of evil. There is no deliverance outside the deliverance of God. You may think you're at ease. You may think you're doing good. You may think you are right. You may think everything's going correct and good in your life. But when you take your last breath, when death has come upon you, that is too late to realize that you have been fooled by Satan and man. See, once you die, that's it. You can't get a do-over. Once you die, you will enter eternity and you cannot come back and redo what you didn't do. Once you open into the gates of hell, you'll be there for all eternity. Once you open into the gates of heaven, you'll be for all eternity with the Lord Jesus Christ, hoping you've done more. Don't think everything's great just because you think, you know, there's no trouble, there's no problems in my life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but shall have everlasting life. God is offering to you life.
I don't know who's shopping.
Eternal life. The assurance that you have or will have rests in the pages of this Bible, that God loves you, that he sent his Son. And America is far from God.
Is that yours?
No.
Thou hast consulted shame to thy house by cutting off many people, and hast sinned against thy soul. God wants you to believe on his Son. God wants you in his book. God wants you in a godly, right congregation church. A true Bible-believing church. And God wants you to send missionaries out. That's what God wants.
Yeah, he just went through here.
Thank you.
Yep. Gotta go straight down through there.
Yep. Are When you don't do what God tells you to do, it's rebellion. Rebellion, the Bible says, is as a sin of witchcraft. All sins are sin. There's no degree of sin. For all have sinned. Just because you haven't done what I've done, I haven't done what you've done. For the Lamb of God which take away the sin. When God takes away the sin, He puts it all one lump sum. All sin. Christ will wash you of all sin, not this sin or that sin, but all sin. You can be cleansed. You can call upon God as your Savior. And the Bible says, these things are written unto you that you may know you have eternal life. You can know these things. Death is coming. And you think, oh, I got tomorrow. I got next year.
Emma.
But guess what? There are plenty of people that never woke up this morning thinking they had today to do their to-do list. They are in heaven or they are in hell. And they can't come back. If you were to die right now, where would you be? And where is your authority on your answer? Remember I said Jesus fulfilled 48 prophecies. 100%. You've got to have the 100% assurance of where you will go when you die. And anything outside the testimony of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, you won't make it. And let me tell you something about hell. There's no party in hell. Alcohol burns up. Alcohol with fire evaporates. So you can't drink in hell. There's no more alcohol. The Bible speaks in the Gospel of Luke that there's tormentation in hell. You think you're going to want to meet with your friend as you burn from head to toe for all eternity? You think your friend would appreciate you being there with him? When you can listen to a Bible-believing preacher and know how to be saved? There's no comfort in hell. You can't fathom eternity. It's worse than a toothache.
Can I get out of hell free?
You can get out of hell free by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. If you call upon Him as your Savior, you can get out of hell free. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, for I have believed on the Lamb of God which take away my sin. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no.
So I went before the judge and the police information, see where that goes. Yourself.
I'm going to die one day outside the rapture. And I know when these eyes close,